Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I am available for on-site training, contracting, and code reviews. So, C++ 17 was completed and officially made a standard in 2017. And now the committee has started working on C++ 20 features, and there's been a few things that have been approved, but obviously, we're not seeing widespread compiler support for these things yet, but we do have the opportunity to play with some C++ 20 features, and, well, I have the chance to do that, so I'm going to do it. So we've got the Clang trunk build that's currently available on Compiler Explorer, and I have enabled dash standard equals C++ 2a. So now we can start playing with C++ 20 features. And now they're saying 2a because, of course, there's no guarantee that we'll actually see a version of C++ in 2020. But committee has a good track record. 11 was late, 14 and 17 came out on time. So we expect C++ 20 will probably come out on time. So the first feature that I'm going to demonstrate is initialization of bitfields. So this is kind of fascinating to me. If we've got our struct s, and you would be forgiven if you had never used a bitfield before, but if we wanted to say we've got this bit, this int I, and it takes 3 bits, and int j takes 5 bits, then we might expect that the size of our struct s is going to be 1 byte. And let's see if that's the case. No, it is 4 bytes. That is because we are getting a padding of size s with 3 bytes to alignment boundary. So this is padding that's going to be required for the struct, but it's getting 3 bytes of padding, which means that we are actually only using 1 byte. So if we increase the size of this, we expect to see our padding change, and now it is reporting 23 bits of padding. So we have our struct that is effectively 1 byte, and it contains these two bit fields. Now, before C++ 20, if we wanted to initialize these to some default value, we would have to do it like this. And I don't see anything wrong with this necessarily, but this doesn't really play well with our C++ 11 in-class initializers, and we wanted to be able to do something like this. And now we can. We can specify the default member initializers for bit fields and say that we want these values to be equal to 0, and effectively the compiler is going to synthesize a constructor for us that does what we want it to do. And now we can see the new warnings that we're going to get with our Clang in C++ 2a mode, which we have this new warning that is, warning, this thing is not compatible with C++ 98, C++ 11, C++ 14, C++ 17. And we can indeed see that if we take it back to C++ 17 standards, then we're going to get this bit field is a C++ 2a extension. It is still allowing us to do it. So in this case, this is the kind of thing that you want to make sure, like, your pedantic warnings are enabled for, so you're not accidentally using features that are outside of the C++ specific standards that you've got. Now, obviously, we're getting these warnings because of dash W everything anyhow, and we probably would even without pedantic with this particular example. There you have it. So Clang is good about warning about this in any case, but just be sure to take advantage of your warnings. And this is the first feature that we're able to demonstrate on C++ Weekly for C++ 20 or 2A, as it is currently being called by your compiler vendors. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.